So in this video here, we're going to see how we can train a custom object detection model with YOLOv8 from Ultralytics. We're going to see how we can set it up. We're also going to see how you can label your data with a specific tool. You can use like whatever tool that you want. How can we actually like export it into the YOLOv8 format, import it into a Google Colab notebook, and then we're going to train our own custom object detection model with YOLOv8. So let's not jump straight into Google Colab notebook. Let's see how we can set it up. It will be down in the description here under the video, so you can use it on your own custom dataset. So first of all here, we're basically just going to set up our NVIDIA SMI just to see what GPU we are running on. If you want to use the GPU, make sure that you go up to runtime, change runtime type, and make sure that you actually like have chosen a GPU as the hardware accelerator. So yeah, we have done that now. We should be able to call this NVIDIA SMI command. Here we go. We can see the information about our GPU right now. This is just like the standard GPU in a Google Colab notebook. Again, you can use the free version as well, and you can run this fine and train your own custom YOLOv8 model from Ultralytics. So now we're just going to pip install Ultralytics here. So now we can see that we have installed Ultralytics in our environment. Now we can go down and install YOLOv8, or basically just set that up. So from Ultralytics, we're going to import the YOLO model. There we go. Now we have imported the YOLO model from Ultralytics. Now we basically just need our dataset. So I'm using like Roboflow in this video to go in and label my dataset. You can use whatever tool that you want. I have the dataset here. Let me just go in shortly to show you guys that. So I just have a dataset with a number of different cups. Then I've just labeled it here with this annotation tool. I'm basically just drawing bounding boxes around it. So you can just drag the tool, draw a bounding box around the object, and then choose whatever class that you want to like have your object in. After we've done that, we can then go in and export our dataset. So I have some versions already generated. We hit export dataset, and then we can select the format. We're going to go with the YOLOv8 format from Ultralytics. Then we can hit show downloadable code. So we just get a code snippet, and we can just copy paste that into our Google Colab notebook. So I've already copy pasted it here. First of all, you just need to copy paste in your API key. Then when we run this, we act like just download our dataset, and then we'll have our dataset in our Google Colab environment. And then we can just directly train our YOLOv8 model on that. So now we can see that our dataset has been downloaded. We should be able to go over into our folder. We can see we have this cup detection version 2.3. We can see we get a test set, validation set, and also a train set. So yeah, we just have some test images. We also have the labels here. So this will basically like be the bounding boxes. We have the label, and then we also basically have the top left corner and the bottom right corner. So this is the YOLOv8 format from Ultralytics. If you go down to the data here, I just want to make sure that we actually like have the correct path, because we're using this in a Google Colab environment, and we actually need the directory for our images. So I'm doing a copy paste that. There we go. And we also have our train. You probably also need to do this here because we're using a Google Colab environment. You can also have your data set in a Google Drive and then just connect to your Google Drive. Then we basically have the path to our test set, train set, and also our validation set. We're just going to save it, and now we should be able to run it directly in our Google Colab notebook. So now we have this YOLO command. We're going to set the task to detect for object detection. Then we also have this mode. We set that equal to train because we want to train our own custom YOLOv8 model now for object detection. We can choose which of the YOLO models that we want to use. In this example, I'm going to go with the medium model. And now we also just need to specify the location to our data set. So that will be the path to our data.yaml file that I just showed you. And then we also need to specify the number of epochs and image size of the images that we actually like train our model on. So now we can just directly go in and train our YOLOv8 model. So now we can see the training has started for our custom YOLOv8 model. It is going pretty fast because we're using the GPU here in Google Colab. Now we can go into the metrics that we get while our model is training, just to verify that we actually like learn whatever we want to. I usually look at the mean error position. So that is probably like the most important parameter. We both have the mean error position of 0.50 and also 0.50 to 0.95 in intervals of 0.05. And those should act like be increasing over your number of epochs, and ideally they should be close to 1. Okay, so our custom YOLOv8 model is now done training. We can see that we end up at a mean error position of 0.50 at around like 0.81, 82. And we also have like a mean error position of 0.50 to 95 of around 0.5. You can just directly go in and download the weights from here. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how we can export these weights and basically just create another instance in our own custom Python script with a YOLOv8 model, and then use the custom trained one instead of a pre-trained one, and also how we can run live inference with our own custom trained YOLOv8 model. So here we're basically just going to plot the confusion matrix. We can see that it actually like does a pretty good job with our detection. So ideally we should have all the values here in the diagonal in our confusion matrix. Let's take a look at the training results. So these are all the graphs from our training results for the metrics. So we can see that the mean error position 0.50 is increasing. Now we can go ahead and take a look at the validation. We can choose the best model that we have actually like trained, and we specify the dataset location for our validation set. And then it will just do validation on images that the model hasn't trained on before. Still look fine on our validation set, even though that these images have never been seen by the model before. Let's now do the prediction mode. So I'm basically just going to have a for loop running through all the images that we have in our detect and predict folder. There we go. Now we should be able to see all the predictions. So sometimes we miss some predictions, but here we see that we're basically detecting like all the cops with the correct labels. Here we miss some detections. Here we get some nice predictions again. Pretty high confidence score, and we're only using the medium model. So this is how you can train your own custom YOLOv8 object detection model. So thank you for watching this video here. I hope to see you in the next one. It should be really exciting to run it live on a webcam. I hope to see you in that video, guys. Bye for now.